short video on Dr. Agarwal, and then we will hear from the legend himself about his stories. So over to Srinivas for the video, please.
Yep, 1 second.
सिर्फ आंखों में ही नहीं, हमारी हिम्मत और हमारी चाहत में भी होते हैं, और जहां चाह होती है वहां राह भी होती है।
सेक्टर के जो भी महान लोग थे, जो दिव्यांग में काम कर रहे थे, जब मैं उनसे मिला, बातचीत किया, तो उनके भी यही रिमार्क्स थे कि ब्लाइंड आदमी कुछ नहीं कर सकता, और आप बैठ जाइए घर पे, अपना कुछ एक कोई एफडी करवा लीजिए पिताजी से और अपना जीवन जी लीजिए। तो उस तरह के जो रिमार्क्स थे वो किक का काम किए, और जब समाज ने उल्टा कर दिया आपको, एंड देन यू टोल्ड कि नाउ लेट्स सी कि अब ब्लाइंड लोग क्या कर सकते, तो वो सर मोटिवेशन का था। To create such awareness inside our community about people with disability, that they don't need sympathy, they need skill, they need empowerment, they need education. So we have to work on all those principles and create awareness among society. I think this awareness can create, I think, in a bigger way, empowerment of people with disability. हमारे बड़े मेट्रो सिटीज हैं, मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टेट कैपिटल्स हमने कवर किए, और पिछले 2019 अगर आज हम बात करें तो करीब 18,000 दिव्यांग लोगों को रोजगार मिला, और जो 2008 में एक भी कॉरपोरेट नहीं था वो अब 1000+ पे चले गए, और सेक्टर्स बढ़ गए, जैसे रिटेल, हॉस्पिटैलिटी, ऐसे ही बढ़ के मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, ई कॉमर्स, बैंकिंग, इंश्योरेंस, हेल्थ, आई थिंक सब सेक्टर्स में इन बच्चों का रोजगार मिला।
तो आपको इस
Now, people from smaller NGOs, people from the rural part of India, it's my humble request to them to spread this information all across India, where they can share with people with disability. We are ready to train people with the NGOs, smaller NGOs, so maybe 1,000 or 100 Sarthaks can be created independently in different part of India, because we have to empower rural part of India. Optimistic person, I always feel nothing is impossible in this world, and if we are getting any signal, so that signal is not from us, from the God, and I feel fortunate that God has chosen me for this empowerment, and my, you can say, body is nothing, it's an instrument, my guru says it's an instrument, and till my last breath I have to serve people with disability.
So parents, stakeholders and NGOs need to support Sarthak in enrolling these differently abled for their training and eventual placement for jobs. In their spirit of innovation, Sarthak is now building an SGRC, a global research center in Gurugram, and needs the generous support for its fructification. My very best wishes to the entire Sarthak team in the fulfillment of its mission. Thank you so much. नमस्कार।
Samaro for inviting me. I think as mentioned by Majumdarji that today we are celebrating 13 years of our journey, and in the morning we have panel discussions. So maybe I'll brief you like how, so I was a practicing dentist till 2004, and 2004 when I was there in my clinic, I found that I can't see the patient. Means I was doing some process, so maybe I thought it might be, you can say, extended hours of work, maybe some, so I need relaxation. But I think 5-7 days, I realized it's a challenge. And then we went to doctor, the ophthalmologist, he diagnosed me with macular degeneration. So you can say 2004-2007, it was looping in the darkness for me. I explored my livelihood, and then I realized challenge faced by people with disability, especially in India, because population in India, when we talk about the number of people with disability, it's like 130 to 150 million people with disability. So number is huge, and you can say support structure is very less. So as a professional, I thought how I can contribute, and then I researched across India. I found that there were organizations working for people with disability in different sectors. They were providing training, they were providing, you can say, support appliances to people with disability. But I think they were mostly were not aware about how to give them livelihood in private sector. And so as a professional, I thought to contribute for this cause. And then we founded SARFAC in the year 2008. And initially, because our target was to give employment to people with disability in private sector, so we approached corporate houses initially. But generally, I think in India, I think they were not a single corporate was ready to hire, because they were not aware. Awareness was lacking as far as hiring of people with disability, because they generally used to ask that how they will come, what they will need. And I think that was total lack of awareness about hiring of people with disability. And then, so from 2008 to 13, we created a plan that we have to first create demand creation in the market for people with disability. And second principle, we have to work for now creating supply chain. So first was demand creation, and then second was supply chain. And so initially, when we were exploring people with disability employability, so initially we approached BPOs. They were a BPO, I remember still, the AGs and NetMBit. And initially when we targeted middle managers, they were not aware, and they told that we can't take decisions. So we went for this top to bottom approach. We initially met CEOs, and then few candidates, you can say, performed in front of CEO, then the CHRO was called, and then the middle manager. So initially, buying came from the top management, and then it floated from top to bottom. And so few BPOs hired people with disability. Then we have a roundtable conference with these BPOs, and the conversion started. Similarly for retail, so when we talk about retail, so Future Group and Vishal, Mega Mart and Lifestyles were initially hired people with disability. Then hospitality, Lemon Tree and ITC. So you can say Lemon Tree in India is pioneer in hiring of people with disability, and their around 15-18% workforce is people with disability. And then came e-commerce like Flipkart, Amazon, Walmart. Everybody is hiring people with disabilities. So first principle, we worked in the was a demand creation, and then we thought how we can source people with disability, because there was no structured database with the government or with the NGOs. So we went from Srinagar to Chennai and from Ahmedabad to Guwahati to organize job fairs, around 100 such job fairs, 60,000 youth with disability registered, 3,000 got the job, and then we realized what is the challenge, why not 57,000. So we were able to, you can say, analyze that skill set of people with disability was not matching the market requirement, and we have to plan a structured training program for them. So we started first center in Delhi and then went to Mumbai, Pune, Hyderabad, Kolkata, Chennai, Lucknow. So most of the state capital we operate, we have 24 centers now with different foundations like NSDC, Cognizant Foundation, Capgemini Foundation. Then we have this thing, and most of Credit Suisse Foundation. So like that, most of the corporate who invest in disability space in India are our partners now. And you can say from 2014 to 21, now around 22,000 youth with disability are employed with us. Have been given successful placement in 1,000 plus corporate, where not a single corporate was there. So this is our, you can say, flagship program of training and employment, where we started and we are moving now. We also have a program for children who are born with disability. So that is called early intervention, where we are identifying children with disabled needs in the government hospitals, in bigger hospitals, and then counseling for the parents to bring them to our early intervention centers. So in that program, around 2,500 children are medically rehabilitated. We work in education space also, especially in government schools, where we have created resource center for children with special needs. Then we also have Abilympics. So this is Abilympics is a movement that started in Japan in 1983, and there are skill competitions. So right now Olympics are going on. So Olympics are, you can say, athlete competition. This is skill competitions for people with disability. And India participated since 2001, and we are mandated by Government of India to first conduct regional, national, and then international. So our international participants are traveling next year to Russia, Moscow for international participation. India hosted international in Abilympic competition in 2004, when Honorable Prime Minister Vajpayee and Dr. Kalam inaugurated that function. So it's like Abilympics is a movement that started in Japan, and now it's covering around 200 countries are participating in these events, and with God's grace, that is there with Sarthak in India now. So this is a brief about our program that we do. And in last 1.5 years, there is total transformation of the organization from physical to digital, because especially for people with disability are more prone for corona infection. So all our program, like when we talk about early intervention, so there is online therapy program going on with children with special needs, especially training parents at home so that they can provide therapy to children with special needs. Similarly, skill program is going online with all the candidates all across India in different formats. In work from home model, I think they are getting employed. Around 3,000 youth got employed also. At Abilympics, training is going online. So everything is online for people with disability. And this is, you can say, diversity. This is opportunity for people with disability in adversity, because it's a golden era. Digital era is a golden era. I think they need not to come out from the house, face the inaccessible transport, inaccessible infrastructure, and enjoying at home. So it's like, and maybe it will be new normal for people with disability in coming years, because it's a successful model that came from corona. Now people will continue this hiring of people with disability, especially in work from home. Second thing, what we did in corona, there is digital transformation. So all the management information system is online now. All the data updated every day now. There's a CapSarthi app we launched with Capgemini last year. The whole idea of this app is any disabled youth in the rural part of India can register, and we provide services. Suppose a child who is getting registered at 5 years of age will get services till 60 years of age. Very, very prominent, around 8,500 people are registered on this app. It's available in 5 languages. We are adding 5 more in phase 2, and it's available both in iOS and Android version. Similarly, we are coming up with a job portal, accessible job portal, first of its kind, It's called Rozgar Sathi, so that people with disability, any disability, can come and have jobs for in India. Then we are coming with the ELMS called e-learning management solution. So globally there is no ELMS for people with disability, and this year and we are launching this ELMS for people with special needs, because now everything is online, so why don't they have ELMS solution for them? So this is brief that we did in Corona, and we also supported. So in 2016 then we analyzed that how we can empower each disabled in India. So we thought we can of course expand our operations, but why not to have partnered with the smaller NGOs in the rural part. So we created a platform called IDEA, Indian Disability Empowerment Alliance. 250 NGOs are part of this platform now all across India, and we are working aggressively on their capacity building for human resource management, financial management, website, social media, fundraising, and we are hoping that they also work like Sarthak in coming years and then have more training and placement program for people with disability. Similarly, we forgot this idea to scale up. We are coming up with a global resource center in Gurugram, with in the video Mr. Bachchan mentioned about this. So we got a land from state of Haryana and looking for support to construct this. I think because of Corona it's got delayed, but we are hoping that this GRC will come live by 2024. And so the objective of this GRC is to have all the solution for all disability at a single place. Secondly, capacity building of the smaller NGOs in India. Thirdly, affordable technology for people with disability for the rural part of India. And fourth, attitudinal accessibility of people with people, especially in corporate, government, and for normal human beings. So this is brief about Sarthak, and we also work very aggressively with the government. We came with, I think from 2016, new right of persons with disability. Earlier in India, there were only 7 disability accepted, now 21. Accessible India campaign also came with our advocacy, then national action plan also came, sector skills. So a lot of policy decisions came from the government, and we feel that the government, we also should partner so that, because they are the biggest skeleton to also the social department, and we are also aggressively working, because when we talk about numbers, I mentioned 130 million or 150 million, but in last census, in 2011, it was just 2.68, that means 26.8 million only. So there's a huge difference, and we are doing advocacy with the government for 2021 census so that we can have a right number, so that government also can plan for this thing. And so our vision is in 2025, we have to give employment to 1 lakh people with disability. And in last 13 years, like, we started with eight children with special needs, but through our outreach program, we have touched around 1 million people with disability who are part of our database. Our team has one-to-one interacted with them, provided them passes or some solutions to people with disability. And the whole idea is to spread this mission to other countries in this series. Last year, we registered within UK, and Sri Majumdar is our international board member, and we are also planning to start in US and Canada and other countries. So that it's a vision now which will go to maybe 100 countries, and you can say empower people with disability on this earth. So I think this is brief about Sarthak, and thank you very much to all of you for listening to me, and I'll be happy to take any questions if you
have. चलिए जी आगे बढ़ते हैं. डॉक्टर अर्चना, आप किधर हैं? आप मुझे नजर नहीं आ रही.
यस यस, I'm here. मैं हूँ यहाँ.
चलिए जी, आप आज हमें क्या सुना रहे हैं?
चूंकि ये रियल लाइफ हीरोज की बात है, तो कुछ सैनिक के सुनाऊंगी मैं. कोई कुछ बोल रहा था शायद.
नहीं, वो एक मिलिट्री ज्वाइन कर रहे थे तो उनका.
देश की आजादी के लिए लाखों लोगों ने अपना जीवन कुर्बान कर दिया, और स्वाधीनता दिवस आ रही है, उसकी अग्रिम बधाई आप सबको. उन्हीं वीर सपूतों को समर्पित है मेरी आज की कविता सैनिक, और उसे पिरोया है मैंने एक फिल्मी गीत के साथ, जो कि मैंने इसी समारोह से सीखा है आप सब लोगों से. एक युद्ध के मैदान में अपना बलिदान देते समय एक सैनिक की इच्छा को व्यक्त करता है ये गीत. फिल्म हकीकत का ये गीत कैफी आजमी जी ने बखूबी लिखा है. विथ ऑल ड्यू क्रेडिट्स टू द मेकर्स ऑफ द सॉन्ग आई प्रेजेंट माय पोएम सैनिक. सीना तान फौलाद सा जो दुश्मनों का संहार करने निकलता है. सीना तान फौलाद सा जो दुश्मनों का संहार करने निकलता है. जान अकेली पर लिए वो सीमाओं पर निडर फिरता है. हम महफूज हो विचरते रहें, जीवंत हो देश की समृद्धि में अपना योगदान देते रहें, ये वो अपनी मुस्तैदी से सुनिश्चित करता है. वीरता की हर सीमा लांग, सीने पे गोली खा खून बहा, वो निश्चय ही देश का अभिमान ऊंचा करता है. वीरता की हर सीमा लांग, सीने पे गोली खा खून बहा, वो निश्चय ही देश का अभिमान ऊंचा करता है. कर चले हम फिदा जानो तन साथियों, अब तुम्हारे हवाले वतन साथियों. सांस थमती गई नफ्स जमती गई, फिर भी बढ़ते कदम को न रुकने दिया. कट गए सर हमारे तो कुछ गम नहीं, सर हिमालय का हमने न झुकने दिया. मरते मरते रहा पाक पन साथियों, अब तुम्हारे हवाले वतन साथियों. उसके इस बलिदान में शामिल है उसका हर एक पारिवारिक सदस्य. आंसू पीकर मुखाग्नि देना है इनके अदम्य साहस का परिचायक. आज आराधना तुल्य इन आत्माओं का सर झुका के नमन. देश की उन्नति और समृद्धि में अपना योगदान निरंतर बनाए रखने का संकल्प ले आज अर्पित करते हैं हम उन्हें श्रद्धा सुमन. इस इच्छा के साथ कि हम उनकी ये इच्छा पूरी कर सकें, आगे गीत की कुछ पंक्तियां जो एक सैनिक की इच्छा दर्शाती हो. जब वो वहां प्राण त्याग रहा होता है मैदान में, राह कुर्बानियों की ना वीरान हो, तुम सजाते ही रहना नए काफिले. फतह का जश्न इस जश्न के बाद है, जिंदगी मौत से मिल रही है गले. बांध लो अपने सर पे कफन साथियों, अब तुम्हारे हवाले वतन साथियों. आइए हम सब मिलके प्रण लेते हैं कि जिएंगे तो देश के लिए और मरेंगे तो देश के लिए, जैसे जितेंद्र जी कर रहे थे. वो भी तो आखिर एक सोल्जर ही है. धन्यवाद.
वंडरफुल वंडरफुल, दैट वाज ब्रिलियंट. थैंक यू डॉक्टर अर्चना.
थैंक यू. ब्यूटीफुल. आई जस्ट गॉट इट ऑन टाइम.
हमारी ब्यूटीफुल
ब्यूटीफुल
भी आ गई है.
Thank you.
Where are you?
Thank you. I'm at